Good morning to all students. Now in this third video of optimum design system, we are going to learn certain concepts of design for assembly and design for manufacturing and design for forging. So we'll see one by one. So design for assembly guidelines. The important aspects that we have to remember for DFA guidelines is that the reduce the part count and type as minimum as possible, ensure parts that cannot be installed incorrectly, strive to eliminate adjustment. If you want to make some adjustment, okay, so whatever the adjustments are going to be there, you should strive to eliminate those adjustments. Ensure parts are self-aligned and self-locate. Ensure adequate access and unrestricted vision. Ensure parts are easily handled from bulk. Then minimize reorientation. That means assembly in Z-axis and secondary operation during the assembly. And make parts symmetrical or obviously asymmetrical. So these are the general DFA guideline. So in short, what are the important things that we have to remember? What are the part count is there and its type? It should be as minimum as possible. Then always ensure the parts that cannot be installed incorrectly. Then whenever it's possible, go for self aligning and self location. Then whenever necessary, go for adequate and unrestricted vision. Ensure the parts which can be easily handled from the bulk. And whatever the reorientation is going to be there, minimize that reorientation, especially assembly in Z-axis. So these are the DFA guidelines. So you can see from the figure here, this hole that we want to produce through a plate. So when we are going to apply the principle, now here in this particular case, you can see it is difficult to locate. But whenever we are going to provide chamfers in that particular part, then chamfers is location. So this is what you can say, the principle of self-locating parts that can be implemented for this particular example. Okay, similarly we can see the example. Now in this particular case, okay, a downward motion of this particular tool is going to be like this. So whenever we are going to consider this is somewhat difficult to locate, then what we'll do, we'll go and we'll extend this bottom part of this tool. So it can reduce the alignment. So whatever the extension is going to be there, it can ease that alignment. Similarly, now here, if you are observing this case, here somewhat it is difficult when we want to provide recess between two component mating parts. Then if we are going to provide arrangement like this, then these recess facilities are going to be make that alignment very easy and very helpful. Then the next is fastening. Now for fastening purpose, consider the least expensive fastening method that meets the requirement. Okay, so whenever we are going, for example, snap fit. Okay, so snap fit generally very cheaper fastening arrangement. Now when we are moving from snap fit to this plastic bending, the cost is increasing. Similarly, the cost is going to be rise in case of riveting. Similarly, cost is going to be rise in case of screwing. So you can see whenever fastenings are going to be there, you can go for snap fit, plastic bending, riveting and screwing. So whenever we are talking, whenever we are comparing this screwing with the snap fit, so definitely the cost of screwing is at the higher side whenever we are going to compare it with the snap fit. So this is what we can do, the fastening principles. Now design of forging. So what is forging? Forging is the process of shaping heated metal by the application of sudden blows, or we are going to call this as a hammer forging, or steady pressure, or you can call this as a press forging, and makes the use of characteristics of plasticity of the material. So what is the forging process in general? It is the process of shaping the heated metal by the application of sudden blows, or we are going to call this as a hammer forging. Or in some cases we are going to apply certain steady pressure, it is going to be called as a press forging. So whenever we are going to use the principle of plasticity, then this is what we can say the case of say characteristics of the plasticity of the material. So whatever the method that we are going to apply for the pressure for shaping the material, the primary requirement is to heat the metal to a definite temperature to bring it into the plastic state. Okay, so whatever the state is going to be required for shaping or giving required shape, it should be a plastic shape or plastic state. This may be done in an open hearth that is called as a smith forge. So we know smith forge is very very commonly used in encasement or enclosure where this operation can be performed. For small jobs or in closed furnaces, for bigger jobs. Nowadays forging is important. Industrial process when we want to make variety of high strength component or in case of automobile, aerospace and other many application. Okay, so we'll see the where these forgings can be implemented. Forgings can be implemented by engine crankshaft, connecting rod, gears and jet engine turbine parts and aircraft structural components. So whatever these important things that we must remember while design of forging. The forging process has generally following advantages. The forging process can be used for solid components as gudgeon pin to a large component as a crankshaft. It refines the structure of metal. It makes the metal stronger by setting the direction of grains. Less time is required for complete operation. It reduces the scrap, and whatever the dimensional accuracy of the obtained part is there, it is going to be a good dimensional accuracy we are getting. So what are the general advantages? It can be used for small components such as gudgeon pin to a large component as a crankshaft. Then it refines the structure of metal. It makes the metal stronger by setting the direction of grains. Then less time is required for complete operation. It reduces the scrap and the dimensional accuracy of the product is good. So design recommendation. The forging drawings. First of all, we'll see forging drawing. What are the design recommendation? Forging drawing with complete dimension of the parts to be forged should be prepared. So all the dimensions should be well properly mentioned. Okay, then die design and processing requirement are the controlled depending on the way in which the part is drawn. So here die design procedure is very very important, and that can be controlled using depending on the part is to be drawn. Then the next important thing, whatever the grain flow is there, the grain flow must be aligned with the direction of highest principal stress. So in general, forging design should be developed in consultation with forging user and the forging producer. It is often advisable to use metal flow simultaneous simulation software to study blocker and finisher shape for the forging. So whatever the forging drawings are going to be there, we have to follow some important parts or follow some important instruction. Whatever the die design and processing requirement are going to be there, they should be controlled in such a way that how that part is going to be drawn. The second important thing, the grain flow. The grain flow must be aligned with the direction of highest principal stresses. Then forging design should be developed in consultation with forging user and forging producer. And the last thing, it is often advisable to use the metal flow simulation software to study the blocker and finisher shape of the forging. Okay, now when we are going to discuss about parting line, when the die hulls join together and confine metal in their cavities, the joining line of the die hulls around the edge of the forging surface, it is called as a parting line of the forging. So parting line plays a very very important role here. So you can just observe this the figure. So this line here, parting line is like this, okay, in this direction, and parting line is in this direction, and you can see here the contour of the product here. But if you are talking about grain flow, so you can see here the grain flow is not a continuous flow, it is somewhat disturbed. Okay, you can see here the stress flow line does not remain constant. Stress discontinuities are likely to be occur. So what we are going to do here, we are going to change slightly the parting line like this. So here if we are going to refer this arrangement, so you can see here a certain angle is given to that parting line here like this. So this is what we can say the parting line, and you can see somewhat smooth grain flow is there. But again, if I want to make this component or this feature say more productivity point of view, you can go and refer this arrangement. This is going to be the better arrangement. So you can see both the parting lines are along the straight line, and you can see the stress flow line or grain flow like lines like this, this one like this. Okay, so you can see here this is undesirable arrangement when parting lines are at 90 degree. When the parting lines are included at some angle approximate 30 to 40 degree, it is somewhat desirable angle. But when the parting lines are along the straight line, and if you are going a continuous shape or contour, you can see this arrangement, it can be considered as a better arrangement. Okay, now next is draft. The whatever the die impressions are going to be there, these die impressions are generally made tapered for easy withdrawal of the forging from their dies. Okay, so whenever we are going to provide taper to these dies, then at that time die impressions plays a very important role and we can easily withdraw on them. In fact, whenever the four surface that generally lie parallel to the die motion are correspondingly tapered. Okay, then the next part we are going to discuss is ribs, bosses, webs and recesses. So, whenever we are discussing about ribs, bosses, webs and recesses, it is recommended to avoid too high and too narrow ribs. Okay, whenever we are talking about ribs, so either too high ribs are not admissible, at the same time narrow ribs are also not admissible, and the bosses are also not admissible. So what is general practice? It is generally assumed that we should avoid too high and narrow ribs and bosses for easy metal flow. So you can see from the figure here the parting line is there, but here this part is somewhat easy to convert, but here this part is not easy to convert, or it is not possible to force. Okay, so whenever we are going to observe this figure, it becomes very difficult when large amount of metal has to be moved out of relatively thin webs into such projection as deep ribs and high bosses. So you can see here in the first figure, so parting lines are along the straight line, here parting lines also straight line, but if I am going to compare this metal flow, grain flow, so this arrangement is somewhat difficult. Okay, so here grain flow, it is somewhat in angular direction, but when what I will do, when I am going to make these ribs or this boss section, whenever this dimension is smaller, okay, so these small dimensions we can convert with the help of thin webs, and we can avoid these deep ribs and high bosses. Okay, so what in general, what is the conclusion? It is better to have a taper such as a web towards the ribs and bosses. Okay, so what we'll do here, we'll provide a tapering cross section. Okay, here like this, here a taper will be provided. So what will happen with the help of this taper? You can easily remove this part from the die. Yes or no? So in addition, deep recesses are also found to be easier to force, provided that they have a spherical bottom. So you can see here, so this additional deep recesses that we are going to provide, they are also going to be found to be easier to force, provided that they have a spherical bottom. So yes, dear student, so in this particular video, what we have discussed, we'll just make a summary. So in this particular video, what we have discussed about the design for assembly guideline. We gone through all the guidelines, what important guidelines are going to be there when we want to apply the principle of design for assembly. So we have also gone and studied various cases for self-locating part. So if you are going to provide chambers like this, it is again a very good arrangement for easy location. When we are going to have certain problem of these tools, then we can go and provide extension arrangement like this, or we can provide excess, we can provide recesses. Then it is also a principle of self-location can be implemented here. Then also important thing that we have revised, that fastening, when we are moving from snap fit, plastic bending, riveting and screwing, the fastening cost is going to be increased. So this part we have also discussed in this particular video. Then we have also discussed about certain design principle. What exactly the forging process is all about, what exactly the basic principle, what exactly which type of software that can be implemented. Then we have also discussed about the various advantages of the forging processes. Then we have discussed about how should forging drawings and parting lines should be there, what is there important, how that grain flow should be controlled, how parting line plays an important role. Then I also in this particular video, we have also discussed about various types of parting line, what is their inclination. We have also seen how the effect of parting line when it is 90 degree, when it is angle of 35 to 40 degree, or when the parting line is perfectly in line. Then we have also discussed about draft consideration, And in the last section of the video, what we have seen that always go for somewhat generalized design for ribs and narrow